from Mr. Emmanuel to them. Stand up, Mr. Emmanuel, please.
Thank you, sir. Islam preached peace. Why are there so many violent incidents associated with Muslims? Example, fundamentalist terrorists. Islam preached equality of gender. Why is it that women of Islam are not allowed to have equal rights of employment in Afghanistan?
Well, I suppose the question that Islam believes in peace or universal religion, why you find they are called as terrorists, as fundamentalists, women aren't given the equal rights, etc. Brother, when I refer to my video cassette, Women's Rights in Islam, Modernizing Outer. This is a lecture 2 hours. This is a question and session for 2 hours. Women's Rights in Islam, Modernizing Outer. And I prove there that in Islam, men and women are overall equal. Just because a particular group of Muslims don't give their rights to the women, that does not mean Islam is wrong. Therefore, I say that women's rights in Islam should not be judged what individual Muslims do or what the Muslim society does. The women's rights should be judged by the authentic forces. That is the Holy Quran and the Sahih Hadith. And in this lecture I have proved there that Islam gives the maximum right more than even the Western world. It gave 14 years ago about economic rights, the right for them to own property, about spiritual rights, about legal rights, about social rights, about educational rights in detail. You can refer to the video cassette. Why particular individual community does? You go and ask them. Islam does not preach that. Regarding fundamentalists, that Muslim is a peace-loving people, why are they fundamentalists? I tell that I am proud to be a fundamentalist. Dr. Zakir Naik is proud to be a fundamentalist. What is the meaning of fundamentalist? A person who follows the fundamentals is called a fundamentalist. So if you have to be a good mathematician, you should know, you should follow and practice the fundamentals of mathematics. If you don't know the fundamentals of mathematics, unless you are a fundamentalist mathematician, you cannot be a good mathematician. To be a good doctor, you should know, follow and practice the fundamentals of medicine. Without being a fundamentalist doctor, you cannot be a good doctor. Similarly, I am proud to be a fundamentalist Muslim. I know, I follow and practice the fundamentals of Islam. But I do know that in the modern context, fundamentalist means terrorist. Terrorist. It doesn't mean what it actually means. A Hindu, to be a good Hindu, you should know, follow and practice the fundamentals of Hinduism. You should be a fundamentalist Hindu to be a good Hindu. For a Christian to be a good Christian, you should know, follow and practice the fundamentals of Christianity. Unless he is a fundamentalist Christian, he cannot be a good Christian. But now the question is, I know that each and every fundamental of Islam, they are good. They aren't against humanity. If the fundamentalist of a particular religion is against humanity, then you can say he's a fundamentalist, but that fundamentalist is a bad human being. There is not a single fundamental of Islam which is against humanity or are favoring humanity. The reason you may think it is against humanity because of lack of knowledge. Either you may not be knowing the Islamic law correctly or you may not be knowing the statistics of the world correctly. Regarding terrorists, a person like the freedom fighters of India, you know, what he calls them, freedom fighters. Desh Bhakt. The British government calls them terrorists. Same man. Same work he's doing. The Indians feel the Britishers had no right to rule India. Therefore, these people are freedom fighters. The British government thinks that they have a right over India. They think they're terrorists. Same man, same activities, two different labels. So depending upon which view you agree, if you agree with the British view, you'll call them terrorists. If you agree with the Indian view, you will call them Desh Bhakt. So a person can be given different labels but different criteria of judgment. If you judge a person correctly, no true Muslim can ever be a terrorist. A few, see, there are black sheep in every community. There are black sheep in every community. That does not mean Hitler. He incinerated 6 million Jews. So can you say Christianity is bad? You are a Christian. Just because Hitler incinerated 6 million Jews, Mussolini killed thousands of people, you cannot say Christianity is bad. Similarly, there are black sheep in every community, but the labels differ upon what view you agree with. Hope that answers the question.